Hello students, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we'll be talking about the relationship between TR and MR. The R in this segment stands for revenue, and it is the income that is generated by business after selling whatever it produces. Let's take a look at what TR and MR are before we study their relationship. So TR means total revenue. In other words, total revenue means the total receipts that the firm would get by selling a given quantity of commodity that it produces. It also means that it is the total income of the firm. How do we calculate total revenue? It's calculated by multiplying the price at which the units of the commodity are being sold times the number of units that are being sold. So it's price into quantity. MR, on the other hand, stands for marginal revenue, and it refers to the additional revenue that is generated by selling one additional unit of output. Throughout economics, the formula to calculate marginals is more or less the same. So the formula goes MRN is equal to TRN minus TRN minus 1. Or alternatively, we can also calculate it as change in total revenue over change in quantity. When we talk about relationship between TR and MR, there are two scenarios that we have to take a look at. The first scenario is where the price remains constant, and the second scenario is where the price would fall with a rise in the output. Basically, these are different market structures, where this refers to the perfectly competitive markets and these are imperfect competitions. In this video, we shall focus only on when the price remains constant. So let us take a look at what is the relationship between TR and MR when the price remains constant. So when we take a look at the schedule here, we see that the price remains constant at 5. The TR is calculated by multiplying price into quantity. So we have TR beginning from 5, which is multiplication between these two, all the way upwards to 25. Marginal revenue, which is the difference between two consecutive TRs, would also be 5 since the price is 5. Now, when we plot these two concepts over the graph, this is how the graph would look like. Now, in this particular diagram, we have total revenue and marginal revenue on the y-axis and units sold on the x-axis. Now, when we take a look at marginal revenue, it is constant at 5. So this is how the marginal revenue curve would look like. It's a parallel line to x-axis. Total revenue, on the other hand, begins from the origin, indicating that there's no revenue earned when the output sold is 0, which is quite logical. From there, it moves upwards at a constant rate. So we can say that total revenue is increasing at a constant rate. And we would get an upward sloping or a positively sloped total revenue curve. Another reason for total revenue to be upward sloping is because MR is constant. When we take a closer look at the schedule as well, we see that MR is equal to AR, which is also equal to price. So let me quickly just jot that down here on the diagram as well. So MR is equal to AR is equal to price. Now, TR is also calculated as the sum of all marginal revenues. Given that the area under the marginal revenue curve, which is this area, this rectangle, would represent total revenue. Let's take a look at how that would happen. So TR is generally calculated as price into quantity. This is the quantity, this is the price. So when we multiply, this entire zone becomes the total revenue. So we can sum that the area under the MR curve represents the total revenue. Students, if you like my video, please do like and subscribe to my channel. And if you feel that my videos are useful, don't hesitate to share them with your friends. I'll meet you in another video with another topic. Bye now. Take care.